Oh, something happened.
Hi there, everyone. Welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I actually got to watch the Cassini spacecraft launch, and I stayed up through the night for its orbital insertion around Saturn and the Huygens probe landing on Titan. And, you know, the lakes of methane, and I always wondered what would happen if you struck a match on Titan. Well, there's no oxygen in the atmosphere, so not a whole lot would happen. But it gets me thinking, well, what if you had a source of oxygen? How would that flame look? So today, I'm going to find out. So I've got a canister of hydrocarbon, in this case propane, but, you know, basically the same. Got a canister of oxygen there, and I can put them in one at a time. And I got a vacuum chamber, which I can replace the atmosphere at will. Let's get a little closer look here. So you can see, I've got a tube going in underneath of this, right there, which narrows down to a little nozzle where I have a sparker for ignition. You can see on this gauge here, I've got a slight vacuum pulled. That's so the lid of this chamber does not pop off. So let's first run the propane into the chamber, which, you know, still has mostly air. And let's see how the flame looks. That way we have something to compare to. Although, of course, we all know what a candle looks like, right? Okay, so we have an atmosphere of air. You can see my little spark. And you might be able to see the little glass tube where the gas is going to come through. I'm actually going to put a little bit of propane gas through that in just a second here. Propane should be going. Let's turn on the spark. And there we go. Turn off the spark. I can probably turn down the propane. Oop, that was up. There we go. Nice little flickering flame. Of course, looks very much like a candle. It's probably flickering because of air currents in there. This is a sudden temperature increase. Now if I just let this burn, eventually it would go out due to the production of carbon dioxide and water vapor, consuming up all the oxygen. But before that happens, I'm actually going to shut off gas, blow in a little bit of carbon dioxide to extinguish the flame. So now, open that valve, I can pull out all the air and replace it with propane. Most of the air has been removed. Not all of it, but there's not enough left to really matter. And actually, if I plug in the spark, you should be able to see there's a coronal discharge going. There's not enough air to sustain an actual spark like you'd normally see. Here, let's turn the light off real quick. There, you can see it just a little bit better, I think. So that's what a spark looks like in a vacuum. So anyway, let's pressurize the chamber with propane now. Taking it back to about the same pressure we had in the first test. This will probably take a while because it's a pretty small orifice and I'm blowing it through. Okay, there we are at about 2/3 of an atmosphere. So let's actually see if the spark will even go across through the propane gas. It should. Yep, no problem. There's a spark in propane. Looks like it is building up a little bit of soot on the electrodes, but not enough to really matter. Carbon's conductive anyway. Unhook the propane. We'll flush the system with some CO2 just to keep it from having a fuel air mixture in the lines here. Oxygen is going in. There it is. Oxygen burning in a propane atmosphere. Oh, that's working better than I thought. Let me turn this light off. That is different, isn't it? It's different colors and everything. It's probably burning hotter. Oh, it's starting to die down. I think that's because my oxygen tank's almost empty. What was making a noise? Oh, it went out. You know what? I want to try this with air. Let's see if I can get air into the system. How can I do this slow enough? Oh, I know. Let's close the stop cock there. Just kind of control the flow with my fingers here. Can spark back on. Okay. Okay. Air does not seem to want to ignite. I guess that sort of makes sense. If you have a fuel that's got a lot of inert dilutant, then it has trouble burning. So I really want to see this burning with air, so I can have almost exactly the reverse of a normal fire. So I've got a little canister here with some compressed air, and I'm currently vacuuming out the chamber. And you should be able to see that I've got a bit of a flame catch going there. It's just a piece of fiberglass. It's to hopefully help the flame take hold. Let's see how the spark works with that there. Oh, that looks cool. The whole thing lights up. Now let's see if it'll stay in place while I inject the propane. Seems to be doing alright. See the little fiberglass threads waving in the wind. So we're back up to pressure with the propane. The fiberglass seems to be intact. Let's see if the spark will work. Yeah, no problem. Air going in. Spark on. Still not getting an ignition with the air. Let's try upping the quantity of air here. That does not seem to be working. And I've let enough air into the chamber now that I'm afraid that it might cause an explosion if I keep going. Probably wouldn't be that bad if it did. There's really not that much propane here. This might be something I'll have to revisit. Well, I guess I'll just... all the air into the chamber and blow away the rest of the propane. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.